Welcome to this video. In this video, we will discuss about types of FSM. We will discuss about what a Mealy machine is, example for Mealy machine, then what is a Moore machine, example for Moore machine, and a comparison between a Moore machine and a Mealy machine. Now into the video. Now we will discuss about types of FSM. Mainly there are two types of FSM, Mealy FSM and Moore FSM. Okay, then what is a Mealy FSM and what is Moore FSM? A Mealy FSM is a machine whose output depends on both present input and present state. And a Moore FSM is a machine whose output depends only on present state. This is the main difference between a Mealy FSM and a Moore FSM. Okay, Mealy FSM, both present input and present state determines the output. And in Moore FSM, only the present state determines the output. That is the difference between Mealy FSM and a Moore FSM. Now we will discuss more about Mealy FSM and Moore FSM. This shows the block diagram of a Mealy FSM. Actually, all FSMs are synchronous sequential machines. Okay, then what do you mean by synchronous sequential machine? In digital system, there are two types of circuits, sequential circuits and combinational circuits. Then what is the difference between sequential circuits and combinational circuits? Sequential circuits are the circuits whose output depends on both the present and previous input. And for combinational circuits, the output depends only on present inputs. This FSM is a sequential circuit. So its output depends on both present and previous inputs. So we need a memory element along with this combinational logic. Then what do you mean by synchronous? Synchronous means it is time dependent. It will change its state only when a clock input is given to it. For example, we can say that there is a memory element in this circuit. Actually, the memory element used here is a flip-flop. Okay, this flip-flop will change its state only when an clock input is given to it. That is like this. This memory element has an additional input. We can call it as clock. Only when this clock is given to it, it will change its state. So, Mealy machine is a synchronous sequential circuit. Now, in a Mealy machine, the output depends on both present input and present state. In this figure, there are two arrows, one from combinational logic to memory and from memory to combinational logic. This represents the next state and this represents the present state. We can write it like this. Okay, this represents the present state and this represents the next state. The output is determined by the combinational logic by considering both the present input and the present state. By combining this present input and by combining the present input and present state, this combinational logic will determine the output, and the next state is determined by the present input. That is the Mealy machine, in which the output is determined by both present input and present state. Next, we will look at an example of a Mealy machine. In this example, There are three states, state A, state B, and state C. As we discussed earlier, these states are represented inside a circle like this. Okay, and these lines with arrow represents the transition from one state to another state. Each of these lines represents transition from one state to another state. And this represents a combination of input and output. This one represents input and this one represents output. We will mark it using different colors. Okay, for example, the input is represented by using this red color. We will represent all these inputs using this red color like this. And all the outputs will be marked using this green color. It will help for easy understanding. Okay. So, like this, this combination represents input-output combination. All these values denoted by this red color represents input, and all the values represented by this green color represents the output. And A, B, and C are the three states, and the circle is represented to show the state, and this lines with arrow represents a transition. This diagram shows that if the present state is A and the input is 0, then the output will be 0 and this machine will remain in its present state, that it will remain in its current state, that is A. And if the machine is in a state A and the input is 1, then the output will be 0 and there is a transition from state A to state B. We can see that the output, this is the output. This output is determined by both the present state and the present input. That is, if the present state is A and the present input is 0, the output will be 0. And if the present input is A, sorry, and the present state is A and the present input is 1, then the output will be 0. And this transition is determined by the present input. If the present input is 0, it will remain in its states. And if the present input is 1, there is a transition from state A to state B. Likewise, if the current state is B and if the input is 1, then the output is 0 and there is no transition. Okay, it will remain in its own state. And if the current state is B and the input is 0, then the output will be 0 and there is a transition from state B to state C. That is, this output is determined by both this current state or present state and present input. If present state is B and present input is 1, then output will be 0. If present state is B and present input is 0, output will be 0. If the input is 1, there is no transition. It will remain in its own state. And if input is 0, there is a transition from state B to state C. And if we are at state C and the input is 1, then the output will be 0 and there is a transition from state C to state B. If the present state is C and the present input is 0, then the output will be 0 and there is a transition from C to A. In this state, during this state C, there are transition during both inputs. That is, if the input is 1, there is a transition from C to B, and if the input is 0, there is a transition from C to A, and this output is determined by both the present state and the present input. If present state is C and present input is 1, the output will be 1, and if the present state is C and the present input is 0, then the output will be 0. Okay, and this cycle repeats. This is the example of a Mealy machine, because this output is determined by both the present state and input. That is why this example is called as a Mealy FSM or a Mealy state machine. Now we will discuss about Moore FSM. This is the block diagram of a Moore FSM. The block diagram looks similar to Mealy FSM. Like a Mealy FSM, Moore FSM is also a synchronous sequential machine that we have already discussed. Difference between Moore FSM and Mealy FSM is that Moore FSM, the output depends only on the present state. The output does not depends on the present input. This present input is only used for transition. This output is determined by the only present state. Like this represents the present states, and this represents the next state. This present state determines the output, and the next state is determined by the input, present input. Now we will look an example of Moore FSM. This is the example of a Moore FSM. Okay, there are 4 states in this Moore FSM: state A, state B, state C, and state D. There are 4 states are there: state A, state B, state C, and state D. Each state is represented inside a circle, and these lines with arrows represent transitions. Okay, the difference between the example of Mealy FSM and Moore FSM is that the output is represented inside the circle, because in a Moore FSM the output is determined by only the present state. It is not determined by present input. So if the present state is A, then the output will be always 0. Likewise, if the present state is B, then the output will be 0. And during the state C, the output will be 0, and during the state D, the output will be 1. Which means this output only depends on the state. Okay, if state is A, output is 0. If state is B, output is 0. If state is C, output is 0. And if state is D, output is 1. But in Mealy FSM, this output are determined by both the present state and present input. So like this: if present state is A and present input is 0, the output is 0. And present input is A and present state is A and present input is 1, then the output is 0. Okay, you don't understand, because in both cases the output is 0. We will take C as an example. During this state C, if the input is 1, if the present state is C and present input is 1, then the output will be 1. And if the present state is C and present input is 0, the output is 0. So During the state C, the output is not constant. Okay. It is also determined by the inputs. But in a more FSM, there is no difference in the output. That is, for the output is determined by only the state, current state, not any input. So during the state A, the output will be always zero. During the state B, the output will be always zero. And during the state C, the output will be always zero. And during state D, the output will be always 1. So this 0, this 0, this 0, and this 1 represents the output during each state. And this shows the inputs. This inputs in more FSM is only used for transitions, which means during state A, if the input is 0, then there is no transition. It will remain in this state. And if the input is 1, there is a transition from A to B. And during this state B, if the input is 1, then it will remain in this state. And if the input is 0, there is a transition from B to C. And during this state C, if the input is 1, then there is a transition from C to D. And during this state C, if the input is 0, then there is a transition from C to A. And during the state D, if the input is 0, there is a transition from D to C. And during the state D, if the input is 1, then there is a transition from D to B. Okay. So, from these examples, we can understand that in a mealy FSM, the output is determined by both the state and input. But in more FSM, the output is dependent only on the present state. Let us compare both this mealy FSM and more FSM. This is the example of mealy FSM, and this is the example of more FSM. Actually, both these FSM represents the same machine. Each and every machine can be represented as a mealy FSM or a more FSM. Okay. What is the difference between this mealy FSM and more FSM? In a mealy FSM, the number of states required is less than or equal to the number of states in Moore machine. And the number of states required in a Moore machine is greater than or equal to number of states in a mealy machine. So we can say this. This is the mealy machine and this is the Moore machine of the same system. Here, in mealy machine, the number of states are 3, A, B, C. And in this Moore machine, the number of states are 4, A, B, C, and D. So we can say that the number of states in a Moore machine is greater than or equal to the number of state in a mealy machine. And the reverse is also possible. The number of state in a mealy machine is less than or equal to number of states in a Moore machine. We can say that, for example, in this mealy machine, the output can be 0. Okay, in the state A, both outputs are 0. During state B, both outputs are 0. During state C, these outputs are different. So, the maximum possible outputs are 0, 0, 0, and 1. Okay, we can say that in this case, during the state A, the both outputs are 0. So this state can only have one output, 0. And during the B state, in this case also, both outputs are 0. So during state, it has only one output, 0. But in C state, if the input is 1, then the output is 1. So, and if the input is 0, then the output is 0. So, the maximum possible outputs are 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, this Moore machine also generates this output. That is, during state A, its output is 0. During state B, its output is 0. During state C, its output is 0. During state D, its output is 0. That is, here also the outputs are 0, 0, 0, 1. That is 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay. So both this Mealy machine and this Moore machine generates same sequence. From this example, we can say that for every Mealy machine, it can be represented by an equivalent Moore machine. And each Moore machine can be represented by an equivalent Mealy machine. Okay. And also we can see that these both machines generate same output, but the number of state required in the Moore machine is greater than or equal to the number of state required in a Mealy machine. That is because in this case, for example, during state A, at any case the output is 0. This is equivalent to this, because during this state A, the output is always 0. And here also, during state A, if the input is 0, output is also 0, and input is 1, then output is also 0. That is, in both these cases, the output is 0. So we can represent this whole process as a single state. During this state B, if the input is 1, then output is 0, and if the input is 0, the output is also 0. So in both the cases, the output is 0. So during the entire B state, the output is 0. So it can be also represented as a single state. But during state C, if the input is 1, then output is 1. And if the input is 0, then output is 0. So the outputs are different for each input. If the input is 0, the output is 0. And if the input is 1, the output is 1. So during the state C, the output is not same for each input. So we have to represent this as two states in a Moore machine, since each state has a definite value. Okay, the first case, if the state is C and if the input is 0, then the output is 0. This state is represented as C in Moore machine. And the second case, that is if the present state is C and present input is 1, then the output is 1. And this is represented as a separate state and it is named as D in a Moore machine. Okay. And also the sequence of outputs are same. The example, during state A, if input is 0, then it will remain in the same state. Likewise, if the present state is A and input is 0, it will remain in the same state. During the state A, if the input is 1, there is a transition from A to B. Here also, during state A, if the input is 1, then there is a transition from A to B. Same. During state B, if the input is 1, it will remain in the same state. Here also, during the state B, if the input is 1, it will remain in the same state. And during the state B, if the input is 0, then there is a transition from B to C. Okay. Here also, during state B, if the input is 0, then there is a transition from B to C. Here, during state C, if the input is 0, then there is a transition from C to A. Here also, during state C, if the input is 0, there is a transition from C to A. During C, if the input is 1, there is a transition from C to B. Okay. Likewise, there is a small difference in this case. If the present state is C and the input is 1, then the output must be 1. And this is represented as a separate state. So, if the present state is C and the input is 1, then it will go to another state which is D. There is a transition from C to D. And during the state D, if the input is 1, there is a transition from D to B. Okay. That means here, the state C is represented as two separate states in a Moore machine. Okay, because of two separate output combinations. That is why the number of states are more in a Moore machine.
Thanks for watching this video.